Hey guys, this is Jonathan from Hexplore It, the Valley of the Dead King. I wanted to just give a quick introduction to the video you're about to see. We actually played a three-player game last night based on the roles that you all selected on our website. So the roles that you'll see played here are the Wilder. That would be a sapping class. We played the Apothecary, that's a healer, and then we played the Summoner, and that is a striker. We played double up, so the game was a little bit quicker. It was still a two-hour game because we were having quite a bit of fun. We didn't want to face the Dead King on easy, so we kicked up the difficulty to difficult. And we just barely survived. So it was a lot of fun. Again, the game was about 2 hours. We hope you enjoy the video, and thanks for your support. Really appreciate it. Enjoy.
The party bonuses you can buy and stuff like that from the last time we played. All right, so we have bad guys I'll keep over by me just in case we need to get to them. We have the game turn sequence card here so that we can go through that. Why don't you handle the shrines and ruins? And then I'll give you each one of the market cards because I kind of know what's on those. Okay. So did anybody check to see what we have as our... Why don't I go
ahead and do that? I did not. Beastmaster, Wilder...
I think
Apothecary, yeah. And I can't remember what the fourth one was that was in the running. Sorcerer?
Could be. Let's check Summer? It out here. Summer. I think it was the Summer. Okay, so we have 5 votes for the Beastmaster, 5 votes for the Wilder, 5 for the Summer, and 5 for the Apothecary. So of those 4, Paul, do you want to... Here's the Beastmaster. I'll get out the other one so you can look at them.
I think you had voted to be the Apothecary. Or I had voted you to be the Apothecary.
I'll go ahead and grab the Summoner then.
Okay.
Summoner. So I can be the Beastmaster or the Wilder. Are they both strikers?
No, the Wilder is a sapper. And okay. And the, the Beastmaster is utility.
Do we already have a utility?
No.
What is the Summoner is a striker?
And I'll either do the Apothecary or whatever you don't pick. So whatever it is, because this is going to be a great game with either of them. So
I've never played the Wilder.
Here's the Wilder. You want to read the abilities there?
Energetic pattern and pattern surge.
Do you have an ability that allows you to defend as well as do your other ones?
No.
Okay.
So pattern surge is kind of like a temporary heal kind of thing, is that? Pattern surge increases an ally's health or energy by half pattern surge rank plus half absorbed strike rank.
Right, but it also raises their total hit points as well, their total health or energy.
So is that temporary or...?
Both.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So even after combat they stick?
No, after combat it goes away. I think it's written that way.
Okay.
You want to pick a
Only
race?
One pattern surge can affect a hero once. I think I'll be a Wilder. That'll be interesting.
And I think I will do the Apothecary. So we will have a Summoner, Wilder, and Apothecary.
I'm going to randomly pick my race.
All right. Maybe we should take the exclusive races out just in case.
Yeah, sorry. I did just yank that out of the box. So.
I mean, we could play exclusive races, but I think they probably want to see a game that has normal races and rules in it. We all have our dice.
I'm a Dark Dwarf Summoner.
Dark Dwarf Summoner.
Oh, yeah, you are.
Okay. Let's see what we have here. You guys might not be able to see it just yet. We will have a shot of it later, but the board we've actually got set up in a very peculiar way here. So we'll be able to see how that affects our journey.
I'm going to go with a lizard man.
A lizard man, okay. Yes,
because reasons.
Because Alkadim.
If the Kickstarter hits $100,000, then maybe I'll explain why I'm going to be a lizard man.
I'm a goblin apothecary.
So a dark dwarf, a goblin, and a lizardman.
Walk into a bar. Yeah. Okay, so we're going to fill out our characters here, and then we'll do our quests and circumstances and see what we have. Okay. Poor Oscar, he's excited to come down here and play Explore It with us. Okay, so we start with 2x our food rating in food.
Oh, we're back to starting with some food?
Yeah, yep.
Now, you said we're doing double up?
Yeah, right? Let's play double up tonight. That means we'll be getting double the bonuses here when we fight and kill stuff. And
so my favorite opponent is Spirit.
I'm good against humanoids.
So your humanoids, Kurt?
Undead.
Undead, alright.
Nice, yeah.
How much money do we start with?
We start with 16 gold piece.
Okay. We can buy upgrades now.
Yeah, right away, right? Yeah. So let's actually figure out where we're going to start on the board. We have to roll a d6 to see which of the 6 cities we're going to start on. Kurt, you want to roll the 6-sided die and see what we get?
Number 3.
So that is all the way up here. Okay. And here are your dice. I'll take the little counters and get those out of the way here. Okay, you want to flip over some quests, all 5 of the quests there, and I will get them on the board.
Got a bounty in C.
So boss number 2. That's all the way down here.
Navigates.
We don't have H open yet.
Got B.
Okay, that's going to be right near us. That's a good one.
A.
Okay. Navigate on A, that is here, and that's going to be right there.
And D as in dog.
Okay, good. So that's all the way down here. All
so
right.
2 food for 1 gold?
Yes. Okay. 2 food, every gold that you spend, you get 2 food.
All right.
Let's put...
What's the distinction between these 2 tiles?
There's no distinction. It's just that it shows that it's on the bottom. Yep.
Are they always on the edge? No.
No. Okay.
It just shows your relative position.
Humanoid. I think my goblin is going to be named Crixus.
Rip.
My dark dwarf is named Chair.
Chair! Awesome! Chair! Do you summon chairs, being the summoner of chairs?
His parents weren't the brightest, so they couldn't very well distinguish the difference between proper names and things that they sit in.
I suppose he has 4 siblings, each named Couch, Lounge, and...
It depends on where Mom was when they popped out.
Okay. I'm going to buy an upgrade to navigate right away.
I get to start with 4 on my summoning. That's a good good place to be.
So I upgraded Pattern Surge, Energetic Pattern, and my health and energy, and then I bought some extra food.
I'm also going to up my navigate, so I'll have 3 on all of my starting skills.
Nice.
I've been burned in too many games by having skills of one.
Yeah. I know. It's hard starting out with one. I'm starting out with three for each of my skills, so that's pretty good.
I'm at two, which is not awesome.
Looks like we have two navigate quests on the board, and we have one explore quest, and we have an escort quest, but it's all the way down here. So that's going to be a hard one to get to. Although we do have this quest for the gray slime as well. I'm almost thinking we go this way and take these two quests at the top and then go to City 2. So we start on City 3. I think, do you have the one that has the cities on the back?
No, I have the black market.
Okay, so you have the city market card. Would you grab that for me,
yep,
please? So City 3. Rock Toe encampment, led by the orcish shaman Dregnok. The orcs are a complicated people. Seems like we're in a orcish place. Like, that's a good place for Lizardman, Dark Dwarf, and Goblin Apothecary to start out at.
I mean, we might be, yeah.
We can purchase...
the lesser races there, but...
yeah. We can get handy elixirs for 2 gold.
So I already spent all my money.
I think I'm going to get one of those.
I'll use yours eventually.
Now, your character is going to siphon energy from us, right?
Potentially, yep, depending on what I'm doing.
So I'm going to upgrade one of my energy as well.
Yeah, to use energetic pattern, it looks like I have to, but pattern surge, I do not. So I'm just going to see if... Yep. Hopefully we can see this okay. So I updated my energetic pattern 1 rank. My pattern surge 1 rank, and then my health and energy 1 rank. You can see the little marks there at the top of the hex. And then I ended up buying a bunch of extra food too, so I don't starve to death.
And I, Crixis the little goblin. So let's see, I'm getting a glare here on the lamination. Okay, I think I can get that. Okay, so I increased both potion smithing and my navigate skill, and then I also increased my careful step, which is my defense. I also increased my energy by 1. I bought food. I spent 1 gold to get 2 food, and then I got a handy elixir as well. So I'm ready for adventuring. I know, there's some matter.
Yep. So, Chair of the Dark Dwarf, upgraded Navigate 2x, put 2 points into my health, and bought 2 rounds of food as well as a handy elixir.
Okay, so we have our quests on the board. Let's get our circumstances out. So,
sure.
We're going to get flip 5 of them over.
Vampire, plague beast.
Oh crap!
Direwolves.
Direwolves.
Inclement weather.
Some pretty awful ones.
And living storm.
Wow. Okay. So there's
we got a couple fights on our hands.
There's quite a bit there. okay. So let's begin our journey, shall we? We begin moving at a rate of 4. That is our normal movement rate. We can move cautiously if we do so by moving along a river or a road, or by spending only 1 movement out of the 4, and that allows us to move cautiously. When we move cautiously, we can get rid of a negative circumstance that might happen to us. So, what do you guys think? Dead King is not on the board yet. We could try and make our way over here, but if we do, we can't make it there cautiously. And if we fail to actually land where we need to, we could end up fighting Siv the Siren Queen on the first round of the game. So, do we want to take the road and try and get down here to open up a new tile? Or do we want to try and... make it to that quest.
I think we should try and make it to that quest.
As do I.
Okay, well, let's do it. So maybe what we do is we move three down here, and then we have a chance of not moving at all, or a chance of landing directly where we need to go.
Sure, kind of gaming the wander a little bit if we fail or navigate.
Let's do it. So we're going to kind of head south, west there, and so we move three. We're going to roll all three of our skills. Are blue, yellow, and green. You need to get below your score.
I need two or less on all of them. Nope.
I may navigate.
I may explore. I got some money.
So we are going to wander. So that means, yeah, definitely wander. Now, when you get money, because we're playing double up, you get four gold instead of two.
Nice.
Yep. I missed my survival roll, so that means I also use food.
So otherwise, if you make your explore check, you get two gold?
Yes. Normally, you get two gold when you move, or when you're playing double up, you get four. So we're gonna wander. We wander... Wander graphic is here. We wander south. So now that lets us open up a new tile. Because we couldn't open one before because it was right in the corner there. Here, get these in there too. Now, one thing that our last video with saving throw, they had actually said that you don't actually reveal a hex until you move out onto the border. That's actually not the case. We actually get to reveal one as soon as you go to the edge of the board. Oh, the ninth boss. So let's see here. Yep, it'll have to be something like that. Okay. Now we have an eye, so we don't have any quests on that one. But it does give us a little bit of a chance to go somewhere else if we want to. You want to roll the d6 to see what encounter or the circumstance we have this round?
Six, living storm.
Actually, blind draw from the deck.
Oh, right, sorry. Pleasant weather.
Pleasant weather!
The weather is comfortable and you're moving easier because of it. The group gains a -2 bonus to navigate rolls during the skill phase and may move one extra hex per turn. This condition remains for 4 game turns.
That's pretty awesome.
I'll let Kurt keep track of that because he's got the board.
Yeah, you can do the numbers on the side there and then just check mark as we cross off our rounds. All right. So that's good. So we actually move one hex farther and we get a -2 to all of our navigate rolls. That's pretty sweet. So Dead King is going to possibly join us. We roll a 3 on our d6. Now we would have needed a 6 to have the Dead King show up on the first round of the game. So playing double up, he will. The chance doubles every time. So the next turn it's 5 and 6, and then the turn after that it's 3, 4, 5, or 6. okay. So next turn, should we try and do the?
I'm gonna reset this quick.
Okay. Let's see. Let's go 1, 2. We're gonna try and hopefully we'll make our navigate rolls.
Yeah. So we don't need to navigate.
We actually don't even need to navigate. You're right. Because we are getting the bonus.
There we go.
Cool. So because of pleasant weather, we actually are moving 2 cautious instead of 1, which means we're just rolling our blue and our yellow. I missed
Fail.
Both again.
Fail.
Good thing I don't eat much. okay, so now we're going to do circumstance. You want to roll a circumstance that we get there?
1.
Vampire.
Okay, so we can get rid of them if we want, but this is a double-up game. We're going to get 12 gold out of those vampires if we
I have them. 0 gold.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
Yes, do it. I would agree.
Okay, so they have 14 health. They have 10 energy. We have to just declare what we're doing this turn. So let's see, Kurt, what do you want to do?
I assume we're not playing on heroic this time.
Yes, we're starting on the easiest level of the game. Okay. I mean, we could always up the ante. I'm okay with.
We should probably keep it as is for now.
For now.
All right, well, I'm going to go ahead and summon the Plague Beast.
Okay, so your summon becomes the Plague Beast. I am going to use, and also these have changed a little bit since you played.
Yeah, the rules are different.
Yeah, we've tweaked a little bit so that they're a little easier to play. And all right, let's see, potion smithing. I am going to do that. So one of you is going to get a potion this round. I'm also going to use my goblin ability to locate 2 gold this turn.
I'd kind of like to use energetic pattern. Are you guys okay with me siphoning one energy from you?
Go ahead.
Yes.
Yes. All right, so I'm going to spend 2 energy on my energetic pattern, but I'm going to summon 1 from each of you. I could summon more because my energetic pattern is rank 2, but I'm just going to summon 1 for now because these vampires only have 14 health. Mm-hmm. So the energy damage dealt to your target is equal to your energetic pattern rank plus mental assault rank, which is 2 plus 2, so 4, plus 4 per energy siphon. So that's 1 or 4 from you,
yep,
and 4 from you. So a total of 12, including my mental assault and energetic pattern.
So you will drain them of their energy, which will deprive them of their middle ability here. So,
right.
And that's an entire group energy health damage of 5. So
right.
that's a pretty good one.
Yep, so I will do 12 total energy damage.
Okay. You want to write down the damage on the counter there?
12 energy damage.
They only have 10 energy, so they have 14 health if you want to write that down.
So the Wilder can kind of just take certain abilities out of the game pretty quickly from enemies.
Yep. Okay, so let's see. Let's see what they do. 4. So you just deprive them of that, so that means it defaults to the red ability. You want to read the red ability?
Dual target energy. If one of you run out, both suffer 1 health, and the vampire defends at rank 4.
Okay, so does it say if both of you run out? If one of you run out.
If one of you run out, both suffer 1 health.
Okay, so we have to generate 2 targets. We're going to roll the d10, and we're going to see who is the highest.
Now it looks 7. Like under your new rules here, my summon is not a target unless I use the ability again.
You know what?
If the summoner uses this mastery while already summoning, the summon automatically becomes a target for the round.
Oh, yes. Yeah. That's if you... It is still a target in our group, but if you use that ability in the same round, it becomes an automatic target. So...
Oh, an automatic target.
Okay. Yes, okay. Yeah, and it automatically is the target.
So I'm rolling once for me and once for the Plague Beast.
Yes, yep. 2.
1 for me and 9 for the Plague Beast.
So nice. Myself and the Plague Beast, it sounds like, right?
So you're each going to take 4 energy.
Okay. And that does not reduce me below...
Does it reduce the Plague Beast?
No, 0. He has 14 energy.
Okay, so it doesn't defend. This is an undead creature, so you get your favorite opponent.
I haven't rolled for the actual Plague Beast action either. Mm-hmm. So the Plague Beast is going to do entire group energy and roll survival each round.
Okay, so the it's already out of energy,
yep,
and it doesn't have a survival, so it doesn't roll survival. Yep. So you get to do your bonus
undead damage of 5.
Okay, so you'll want to write that down on the battle mat there. They have 9 health left, and they're out of energy.
All right.
Now, I am going to use the potion on you so you get your energy back.
Okay.
So you get 3 energy back.
Okay.
And it's the next round.
All right. So... I'm kind of thinking I might do Pattern Surge. I'm not sure. Chances are it's not going to hit me again. I'm just saying that, but
sure,
it's probably going to hit me again. So I'm going to use Pattern Surge on you, John, the Apothecary.
Nice thing, too, about using abilities that require a target is you don't actually have to specify your target until after we know what the bad guy's doing.
So I can wait.
So you can wait.
All right.
I'm just going to do Acidic Concoction for 2 damage.
All right, I'm going to use Invocation, which is going to do 3 damage plus twice the level of my summoned creature. So that's going to be a total of 11 damage.
Nice. That should kill it.
And then I will roll for the Plague Beast as well. And He is doing number one, which is a basic attack of 6 damage.
Excellent.
So it should definitely die.
And then the 3 for me. And you get your favorite opponent.
And my favorite opponent is 4.
Okay, so the bad guys do same thing. Dual target energy. If one of you run out, both suffer 1 health and vampires defend at rank 4. So roll our targets. 5.
4-2.
I am going to run out of energy this round.
Oh, and I tied.
Oh.
10.
So.
All right, so I'm going to use Pattern Surge on you to give you 4 energy and
health. Awesome. Is it both, or is it one or the other?
Health or energy. So, energy.
Yeah, that way I won't run out and they can't defend.
That being said, I do run out of energy.
okay, so you were the target then, right?
Yep.
So they do defend this round.
So I hit 0.
But we did enough damage. Plenty damage.
My faithful plague beast runs off into the wilderness.
Awesome. So we just fought vampires in like this rickety old ship in the middle of a bay. That's and they're dead. So well, they're undead, but now they're really dead. So we get 12 gold.
Oh yeah, and you could have rolled your bonus again, right? Oh, you did. Mm-hmm. Okay, perfect. You said 12 gold?
12, yes. Pretty lucrative round, gentlemen.
Yes.
Those vampires didn't have any food on them.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay, so now we have the quest.
I fill these back up, right?
Yes. Yeah. You want to read our quest?
Lucky Rabbit's Foot and Enchanted Hourglass. Ooh. So things are going our way, finally.
Explore. A fleet of destroyed ships lay at rest at the bottom of Brackwater Bay. Would-be adventurers are exploring the wreckage, hoping to find treasure. You're more concerned with finding a clue, which may help defeat the Siren Queen. Go there and search the debris. Challenge. If you choose to camp here, next turn, you uncover a secret that may help in the battle against her. Each hero may now treat Siv the Siren Queen as a favorite opponent.
Ooh, nice. Okay, so this is a explore quest. We need to roll our explore die, and one of us has to make the roll in order for all of us to succeed on the quest.
Nope. You got this, Kurt.
Nope.
No! Okay.
I guess we're camping here.
Yep, we might have to camp. So now, Dead King, 5 or 6.
Nope.
He does not show up.
Right. That's the end of day 2 of Pleasant Weather.
Okay, so we still have a bonus on our green, but you know what? We're not actually rolling a green skill for our quest. That's unfortunate. We're going to roll our blue and our yellow again. Wow. I'm running out of food,
gentlemen.
And
you got some money. But ran out of food. Not out, but I have less food.
Okay.
You said 4 gold?
Yeah. Every time, yep, for with double up.
That is fantastic.
1 enchanted hourglass. You wanna?
Yes. You found a mysterious artifact, a golden hourglass. Keep this card. It is automatically consumed the moment one or more group members would normally die at the end of a combat round. Roll a 10-sided die and add the result to each of the dead member's current health. Discard after use.
Nice. So that's kind fantastic. Of a get out of a jail free card. I'm excited about that.
We're gonna die.
We'll probably starve to death, our idiots.
Right.
First,
most likely.
So let's try that quest again. We're gonna roll our yellow. Come on, 3 or less.
Nope.
Oh, okay. We might have to go back to town because we are running out of food here. Dead King. What is it? 3, 4, 5, or 6. He appears. You wanna roll a d6, see where he takes.
3.
Right next to us. Okay, he's right next to us now. The game got a whole lot more dangerous because he will take the last movement of his turn. He will go out of his way, out of his path to target us. So if his next target is City 2, we are right in the way of him, and he will attack us if we're still sitting here.
Perfect.
So that's pretty cool. Let's see what happens next turn. Okay, one more turn.
We're camping here one more turn?
You know, one thing I forgot to mention, if we camp, we get a -1 on our blue and our yellow roll. So if anybody was one away from...
I wasn't close either.
But it is cumulative, so next, this turn, we'll be at a minus two. So,
all right. Oh, we're also supposed to be getting a... No, we're not.
Just for the green.
Which we're not using.
So let's try it one more time.
All right.
So we're camping, which means we're actually healing as well. So we should all be to full now.
Okay.
We healed three last turn and three this turn.
Oh, I'm actually at six energy then.
Okay.
So blue and yellow?
Blue and yellow.
At a minus two?
Minus two. I made my survival.
I made my survival. So I don't lose any food.
Okay.
Oh, you made your explore?
Yeah, but not for the quest. Just for, just for the general state of things.
Sure.
Okay, and so now we roll for our quest.
You're just keeping the lights on.
Yeah. Okay, I need a five or less. Come on.
Four or less.
One. I made it with a one.
Nice.
Yes.
What's the bonus for the one?
Plus one to navigate.
Navigate goes up by one. Nice. Okay, so what just happened is on skill quests, if you roll a one, you actually get a bonus ability or skill increase. So if we're looking at this card here, if you roll a one, you get a bonus to your green ability.
I can't tell if that's in focus or not.
Okay. So now we are going to mark that quest as complete, and the Dead King moves to...
Well, where does he move?
Oh, he actually doesn't move yet.
Oh, he needs a target.
You're right. He needs a target. So let's...
So D6.
Five.
Not this city thing.
Hey, look at that.
He's going far away. Nice. See, this is where this kind of map is definitely a good thing.
For now, yeah.
Okay, where do we want to go?
Either way, it's the start of our last...
spending some money and maybe turning in that quest.
This is our last...
Well, we could try and do that quest right away and then turn them both in.
And we could take a river all the way there.
It's our last day of pleasant weather, so we get one extra hex on this trip.
We should probably
use it.
So let's
go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that gets us two away from our quest. Or we could
go straight there.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we might not wander.
Right. That's
because
that's
we still have.
Okay.
We still have inclement weather, right?
Oh, guys,
pleasant weather. Sorry.
You know what? We can't go there because it's a mountain tile. We need to get climbing gear first.
We're gonna have to go to the city anyway.
Yep. Unless we'll have to go to the city first.
Okay.
Unless we want to fight boss number one and reveal another tile.
Well, I have one food left.
We should probably go to town.
Okay.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We might end up wandering there anyway.
Sure.
Can we move recklessly into the city?
Yeah, we could.
What are the rules for that?
So moving recklessly, the group moves two hexes further than normal, but doing so is taxing. The forest march is a long and tiring day. Each hero loses two energy. You roll navigate, and you choose to roll either explore or survival. So we just... fail the other roll. Now, since you've played, we actually do roll every time you even go onto a boss or a city. So you might wander off of the city if we don't make our navigate roll. But I'm willing to chance it. I mean,
if we don't move recklessly, we can't get to the city either.
And we have a 50-50 shot of not going anywhere, even if we do.
Right.
And we have pleasant weather, so we do have that minus two bonus to navigate.
Boom, let's do it.
All right.
So minus two, you know what? Don't even minus it, because if we do end up in the city, I'll just pay a gold, and then we'll get all of our health back. All
right.
So
I'm going to fail my explorer by default then.
Okay.
I fail everything else.
I'm going to fail my explorer as well. And I also fail everything. Nope.
You get to choose which one?
You have to choose... You have to roll your green,
yep.
But then you also choose to roll either your yellow or your blue. When you're moving recklessly, you have to at least fail one.
Okay, well, I'm going to fail my survival anyways, so might as well try to find gold. No, I'm both.
Okay, so we wander.
Can't find the city.
Six. Oh, yes. Nice.
So we would have moved here.
Yep.
But since we can't, what a shame.
We landed on the city. I will spend the gold. We all have our our health and vitals back.
Excellent.
If you ran out of food, now you can purchase more.
That sounds like a good idea.
I think I'm going to do the same.
Which city number is this?
2.
City number 2. Dragon's Port. The humans run this shady port and are largely concerned with themselves.
Boo, humans.
Despite this fact, many valuable goods arrive here each day. You may purchase exotic maps for 3 gold.
What are exotic maps?
Exotic maps allow you to pick and choose a map tile to place anywhere on the board. So, for instance, I could go and say, you know what, we're going to, I'm going to actually do that. I'm going to spend 3 gold, and we're going to find tile H, because that way we have a quest on there. Let me get that. Ooh, tile H has both a ruin and a shrine.
Yes, it
does. And a quest.
That's a good tile. You should put it near us. All right, now we completed the quest, so we will get our bonus for...
So the bonus is doubled, so we get...
2 power-ups.
2 power-ups each. Hey, I'm a goblin that lives off the universe. My goblin apothecary unlocked the secrets of not eating.
Ironically, I also got -1 food rating, so...
Nice.
That's always a nice bonus to have. It's
so
one
I will take
thing.
Any food that you guys have, because I eat 3 a turn.
I'll give you 1.
I'm at 1 a turn now, so I just bought food, and I don't really have to worry about it much anymore. But I also got a +2 to my survival.
So we also added little sayings to the cards as well. So my health +1 says, I've been saying it, exercise! My food rating, the universe sustains me.
Mind putting that in the discard?
Yeah.
So while we're in town, I just upgraded my energetic pattern to rank 3. I upgraded my explore to rank 3, and I bought some food.
Okay, I am going to upgrade my potion smithing twice to get up to 6. No, I can't. I don't have enough.
I'm going to upgrade my summoning circle to rank 6.
I gotta reset this quick.
Food.
Alright.
Okay, I'm ready to go.
Yep.
So, let's see, we have a quest on that tile. So, the quest that we have is...
Oh, but we need climbing gear. For this one, sorry.
Yeah, I spent all my gold, so I don't have enough to...
How much is climbing gear?
6. I have 3 left.
Tell you what, I will buy less food since I just got... Alright. So if you want to spend 3, I'll spend 3, and we can get climbing gear.
Perfect.
Do you want to write it down, or should I? I will.
He's actually got...
Oh, he's got, okay.
Got a checkbox for it.
Yep.
Perfect.
Climbing gear. Oh, our pleasant weather is gone.
Yep, so we are no longer gaining that bonus. All right, so dead king moves this turn to closer to his target.
Climbing gear just allows us to climb mountains.
Right.
Well, not just, but...
Yeah.
Clearly that's where we should go next, then.
Yeah.
Right.
And then I think we should make our way down here, grab the blessing, try the ruin, and take out another quest.
Or we could go to boss 1.
We could do that too.
Sure.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to move 2. We're not moving cautiously, so we have to roll all 3 this time. I made navigate.
As did I.
So,
hey, I got
awesome.
One.
We don't
Look
have...
at that. And I made my survival.
Hey, you made a 1. That means on your navigate, that means that you alone... caused us not to get lost. So if that ever happens,
it would have been amazing.
Right. But we all made it.
We had
right. You're like, it's this way. Oh. We're like, we know.
Yeah, we're all right.
We're already there.
Okay. All right. So now we get to do the circumstance. You want to fill out...
Oh, yep. Sorry, I was trying to move that.
Number 4. Inclement weather.
Inclement weather. So
the weather has turned.
No good deed left unpunished.
And we can't get rid of that card, so you want to read it?
So a storm has moved into the region. You are forced to move slowly. Your movement is slowed by 1 hex per turn, and your skills suffer a +1 penalty to each roll.
Ouch.
This affects any skill roll. This condition remains for 4 game turns.
Harsh.
Boo.
Yeah, it's a tough one.
So, we'll leave it here, or...
Yeah, you can...
And then replace this
card.
Yeah.
Do we discard for circumstances?
Strangle lines. Oh, I was putting...
Give me a second. Discard these things over here, too.
Okay, so now we do our quest.
All right, which
navigate,
one are we on?
This guy
navigates.
No. Unfortunately, we're at a...
+1 to the roll, yep.
An old dwarven mine exists here, which used to run underneath the valley. Unfortunately, the entrance has been lost. Go there and search for the entrance. Challenge. You may choose to follow the mine network to its end. If you do, the group will roam twice at the end of this turn. Mm. If you do, each hero loses 4 health to a minimum of 1 remaining. Draw a single power-up card. Each hero gains twice the card bonus.
Yeah, but it's double up, guys. So we get 2 cards each doubled.
That sounds awesome.
That sounds amazing. But we roam twice.
Yeah.
So let's do it. I'm kind of excited about that.
Well, we need to try the quest itself first.
So we're going to roll our green, our navigate.
So now I need that one.
I made it!
I did not.
Nor did I.
Okay, so I rolled a 3.
The Apothecary knows what he's doing.
Right.
So the Goblin Apothecary
tricks
us. The
Dark Dwarf got lost in the Dwarven Tunnel.
Yeah. It's like, hey, it's over here. Okay, so we made the quest. We're going to try the challenge next round. Dead King moves 2, and now it's our turn again. So we are going to attempt the challenge. That means we have to roam.
Wrong. We're going to succeed at the challenge.
You're right. Yes. We are going to succeed at the challenge.
Be the change you want, John.
Could you read the challenge one more time?
If you do, the group will roam twice at the end of this turn. So we don't even wait until the next turn.
Oh, yeah. So it's the end of the turn. Okay.
Yeah, so
so before he moves.
If he moves. The king, yeah, you should unmove him.
Okay. So all right, we're going to roam.
Roam twice.
So you go ahead and roll the direction. I'll roll the distance, and then you roll the direction next time.
Okay.
Direction 6.
So that's that way.
Yep.
5. So we go right to the edge of the map.
Corner.
We're going to open a new map tile.
At random, right?
Yep.
Nope, not you.
I'm so excited. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. And now we roam one more time. So, oh my god. Boss number 8.
Yeah, don't roam into him.
6
again.
Same direction.
3. Okay, so we have to put another tile. We're almost off the table here.
But just think how far away the Dead King is going to be from
us. Yeah.
Got a shrine.
Shrine. Check it out.
You just set us up to go.
1, 2, 3. We end on a shrine. Okay.
It's like we meant it.
So we each lose 4 health.
To a minimum of 1 remaining?
Yes.
Okay. And we each get twice what's on this card, +2 health.
Each of us?
Yeah. And twice what's on this card, +4 health. Holy crap. 10 extra health from that.
12.
Oh, sorry, I can't do math. I'm so excited. I'm at 19 health.
So now, does our current
also
go up?
Yeah, current and total.
And total, yep.
Is that bad?
Well, that will help.
Yeah.
That is quite the stroke of luck.
Still going here? Yep, we're still going.
That may be more health than I've ever had in a game of fiction.
I mean,
by the end.
This early on, yeah. That was an amazing... So
I'm just going to stand in melee now.
So we just got double the power-up bonus for both of these.
And so that one with the outside design is an epic card, right?
Yes, yep. The one is an epic card. So that was +4 health. We each got +8 from that card. That was awesome.
Yeah, that'll help a lot.
And we're in a shrine, which means we heal. And the Dead King moves twice. So we can buy some things here, including teleportation runes. I'm thinking we buy one and we go to one.
I'm pretty sure I'm the only one with any money.
You don't have any money.
How much is a rune?
You know what? You're right. I don't have any money either.
I have four gold.
Can we turn in quests insurance?
We can turn in one quest, so that means we do get one. The quest.
All right. So that's a power-up, which means two power-ups.
Two power-ups for each because of the quest turn-in.
Ooh, I get a plus one to both masteries and a plus two navigate.
I get plus three total your choice and plus one all attributes.
Oh, nice. I got a measly plus two to my yellow, but I'm still excited about that. A goblin who can't explore is not a goblin at all.
It's funny because our last quest, I got two plus healths. That's why I'm at 22.
Holy crap, 22 health? Yeah. So, all right. We can't buy anything because we have no money.
Yeah, I have four gold. That's it.
Okay.
Do we get anything? Is there anything special at this particular shrine?
Yes, we could get.
You can camp there for a blessing, right?
Yeah, which one is that one?
E.
Okay, blessing of good fortune. This blessing allows a hero to sacrifice three energy once per turn to reroll a single die their hero has just rolled. You may choose which of the two results you'd like to take. Do we want to camp here and try and get the blessing, or should we get our show on the road?
I think we should hang on to that and camp and get that blessing.
That's a pretty good blessing.
Yeah. You never know when that's going to come in handy and save our lives.
Right. Okay. So we're going to camp. At the end of our turn, first of all, he moves twice. And then we camp here.
Yep. So we still roll yellow and blue?
Yep. Still going to roll that.
And we have a... plus one is on navigate, which we're not rolling right now because of inclement weather, right?
The inclement weather actually is plus one to all skills.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, behind yellow and blue.
Oh. Yep. I got a one on my explore.
I got a four on my, I'm sorry, I actually made my explore with a roll of a four, so that means I get four gold. We might have enough gold to do a teleportation rune now.
Is there any super special bonus for getting a 1 on your explore?
Yes. If you roll a 1 on your explore during the skill phase, you find an excellent place to camp, and each hero regains 1 lost health.
Oh, well.
We're in a shrine, so we're already healed.
B.
We have an invasion on B. So that is city number 3, which is already fallen. So that actually goes in the discard pile. We have a explore... quest right here.
So how much is a teleportation rune?
Six.
Six.
I'll pay four for that.
I'll chip in the other two. I think you're... Yeah. I'll chip in two more. We'll cover it, Kurt.
All right. Then I have four gold for anything else you might need.
Okay.
So we have a teleportation rune.
Do we want to teleport to here and then move here? Try our luck with a shrine? With a ruin? Or do we want to...
How many turns would it take us to get to boss one? Probably at least two, right? Nine?
Yeah.
Or we could teleport, you know, over here and then come back and fight boss one?
If we teleport here and then we... Boy, it would take forever to get back to a city if we did it... If we went this route, we could always teleport here, then go here, then do the second boss and come up.
Except,
but we don't want to get stuck here with him.
Yeah,
true. Risk of that. So I think this area might be.
Yeah.
So we can hit those and boss one.
Okay. All right, let's do it. So we are going to teleport then directly to the quest. The quest is a navigate roll.
All right.
So let's do that. We get to open up a new location. If you want to grab the hexes there, hex tiles.
I'll let you pick one now.
Thank you.
Nope.
Oh! Ooh, put this right next to us.
John's
look at that.
You always got to game the system.
It's like he meant it.
Okay. So look at all those ruins. I'm just so excited. There's so many there.
And we don't have to worry about the Dead King for a long time.
Yeah. He's like on a different continent. You know what, though? I think we forgot to move him after the...
All right. We're rolling again.
Cool.
Okay.
It's a huge map.
Yeah. I've got
quite a few already.
Let's not go this way anymore. Oscar.
Okay. So we now have our skills. We're going to roll all three of our skills because we used the teleportation rune. We can still get lost using a teleportation rune. But I got a one. So we don't get lost.
So we still have inclement weather, right?
We do.
Yep.
Okay, so I still fail my survival.
By the way, a roll of a one is always a automatic success. So even with the inclement weather negative, we still make the roll. Okay, so now we'll do a circumstance. Six, blind draw from the deck.
Hidden chest!
Hey!
You've uncovered a buried chest. Each player roll explore. If one player succeeds, the group rolls one six-sided die. Each player gains gold equal to the results rolled. This die can explode.
And it's double up, so we get double if we make it. Our roll, is it a minus or a plus
Fail.
One?
Fail.
Fail.
No.
We have the blessing of good fortune now, so I'm going to spend three energy to re-roll that die. And possibly take the better result. It's a one! All right, so that means we get to roll a d6. And
so the group rolls one six-sided die.
Now, if this,
you better blow on it first.
If this goes, you can go ahead. if this goes sour, one of you guys can spend three energy to re-roll.
Oh, and it's gonna explode.
It explodes,
right?
Six. Three, so that's 18 gold we all get.
That's all right.
That's,
I think we can take that.
Awesome.
It's now a bad time to mention that I might starve to death.
We are out in the wilderness. We can go here to the shrine if needed.
I have seven turns worth of food, so I can give you some if need be.
Okay.
I lowered my food rating from 3 to 2, so I'm in better shape now.
Sure.
Nice. You want to put that in the discard?
I have two turns worth of food.
Excellent.
My survival's 4, so I should make it eventually. With
this,
inclement weather, it's not helping me.
This little goblin has an infinite number of turns without food.
Can we buy food in shrines?
You can, yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Then you're fine.
Sure.
Okay, so now we have the quest. The quest is the Navigate quest here.
Navigate. Sentient trees live in this wood. The elves have known about them for quite some time, but the humans are now trying to befriend them. Well, we are neither elves nor humans. Enter the wood and seek out the tree ants on their behalf. Challenge. If you have an elf, half-elf, dryad, or pixie in the group, we don't, so...
Yeah.
Doesn't matter. We will not have a particularly good conversation with the tree ants.
What about Elizabeth?
We may try to cut them down.
We just need some wood, that's all. So we're going to roll our green with a plus one to the roll, remember?
Hey, I made it.
I got a one.
Me too.
A one.
Wow, we all made it.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
So what is the number?
High fives are for ones.
All right. So we get one plus one to our survival.
We do.
Wait, just you guys, right?
Yeah, because we rolled
the ones.
Oh, I
redact my high five.
Yeah, well, I still got it. Okay.
Well, we still completed the quest, right?
Yeah, so the quest is now turn-inable.
Sweet.
Dead King moves 2. Quest goes away, and now it's our turn again. Do we want to try and do the ruin?
Yes.
Sure.
And we can move cautiously to the ruin, right?
We can, yeah. Move cautiously. We're going to roll our...
Day 3 of inclement weather.
Blue and yellow.
Hey, I got a 1 on my explore.
Nice.
Yeah.
Missed everything, though.
So, the 1 on the explore, make sure that...
Everybody heals 1 health.
Okay. Still not useful right now.
Nope. Right. We haven't had to fight anything, thankfully.
One of these days, I'm going to get a legit high five for something I do.
Not helpful.
Not a pity high five.
So we are on a ruin. Do you want to show that to the camera there? Do you want to roll a d10, Paul, and see what we get?
Absolutely. 1.
Oh, snap.
Does that mean everyone's dead?
One.
Do we hex implode?
One is mythic event.
Oh.
You've survived a mythic event. Reduce each hero's health and energy by 5. to a minimum of one remaining. Draw two power-up cards. Each hero gains twice the card reward. We're playing double up. We get to draw four power-up cards, and we get to get double the reward.
So now our current health is reduced by five?
Yeah, current and energy. Okay. Yeah. So I'm out of energy.
I would like my high five now.
To a minimum of one. Yes, you get a high five for that for sure, man. So should we see what's underneath the cards here?
Let's see.
Oops, sorry. Oh, plus one to three.
Plus one to all three. That's a lovely card.
Plus two to energy. And remember, we're getting double the bonus, guys, for each of these cards.
Plus one to
plus one to attack and plus. Okay. So we're getting plus four to our red and orange. This ruin has been very lucrative.
So now, since we were doing double up, it was originally two cards?
So, but the ruin says you get double the bonus for each card.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So we're getting doubled on our doubles.
Yeah.
Okay.
Get four of that energy back.
Four energy.
And then plus six of our choice.
Wow. Plus six of our choice. Distribute this bonus between any of the following. Food rating can drop to zero, so you can use that on food rating if you want.
Yeah. And we're done with that now. So we'll spend one on food rating. You can't spend more than 1 point on any... one ability?
Nope. This particular bonus is distribute the bonus between any of the following. So you can use it any way you like.
Okay.
So I went heavy on my skills. So each of my skills is at a five now.
Nice.
So I'm going to up my pattern surge.
I think we should fight some bosses and try and get the black market to show up.
Sounds good.
Dead King moves two. Did we miss him the move before?
No, we got him.
Okay.
He's just taking a long time to get over there.
Yeah. We're like, sucker! We are going to ruin him.
It's not looking so good for the Dead King right now.
Well, we can always jack up the difficulty and
yes, absolutely.
Do we need to mark that shrine? Oh no, the ruins. The ruins get completed. Shrines.
Yeah, the ruins are that ruin is complete. What do we want to do? Do we want to go into the city and pick up
shrine.
Or the shrine? Yeah, and pick up another teleportation rune. Maybe
wouldn't hurt.
Maybe do boss number two that has a quest on it.
It would also be good to pick up a talisman.
Yeah.
Plus, we can turn in one quest while we're there.
Yes, we can.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Let's do it.
Yeah, so I've got 28 gold right now, so I have plenty to spend.
You were hanging out of that, weren't you?
Yes.
All right, so we move three. We can still get lost, so we're going to roll all three. We did not move cautiously.
Oh!
I made navigate.
There's on the floor, Kurt. You mind grabbing that?
Yeah, Oscar, can you get that?
I passed my survival with my zero food rating, so...
I did not make navigate.
I got some golds.
I did not make navigate either.
So we are going to wander. Do one of you guys want to reroll using the shrine ability?
What does it cost? Two?
Three.
Three energy?
Three energy.
Yeah, I will.
We just need one more navigate roll.
Pass.
Yes.
There you go.
So we don't wander.
Thanks to that shrine, that blessing. Okay, so we are in a shrine. We automatically heal to full. We can buy anything we want that is in the shrine. I will buy us another teleportation rune, which is six. Now, we cannot purchase any upgrades while we're in the ruin.
I will buy the talisman for nine.
I'll give you five towards that, Kurt.
That's more than half of it.
Yep.
All right, I will buy the talisman for four. All right, and we have...
What else can we buy in the shrine?
H.
Well, I don't need a dimensional pouch to carry more food currently.
Mystic Tonic would be good in case we run out of energy.
Negative ongoing effects for one hero or heal 6 energy.
I'm going to buy a couple of Mystic Tonics just to have. How much does that heal again?
6 energy.
6 energy, okay.
Or removes negative effects.
Okay. And it was how much?
2. I'll buy one also.
If you want to give it to me, I can actually increase its use on you.
Oh, sure. Yep, you can have 2 then. I'm also going to buy a Resurrection Scroll, just in case.
Okay.
So you have my Mystic Tonic?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, cool. Dead King moves too.
Can you hold on to one food for me?
Yeah. just to have?
Just to have, yeah.
Okay, next we get to decide where we want to go. Should we take the...
I think we should teleport over to that quest.
Yeah.
We're not going to fight boss one before we go?
Oh, you know what? We forgot to turn this quest in.
That's right.
Oh, yes.
We're in a shrine, so we turn in our navigate quest. We each get 2 power-up cards.
What? So, plus 1 energy, plus 1 defend?
I feel like we can definitely take on the Dead King at any time here.
I do too.
Are these double?
I got 2
epic cards. Okay.
No, it was only the ruin
right.
Because we had the mythic event that doubled it. What is doubled is the number of cards we're receiving. So normally we would turn in the quest and only get 1 card.
Right. I mean, I feel like we've been pretty lucky with what we've gotten for power-up cards. Maybe we should bump up the difficulty.
Yeah, I think at least to, you know... Godly. Epic, I mean.
I don't know.
I mean, why can't we just pump up the jam and see what happens? Yeah, I'm kidding.
All right. Now that I bought all that food, I have 0 food rating.
Nice. Well, you can always
let me hold the food you don't need anymore.
Time to sell it. Yeah, you can sell it whenever you want.
Okay, and we are going to teleport, right?
Yes.
We're not fighting boss one?
Yeah, let's do that first. Let's do that first because we're right there. Good call.
Okay.
So we have to, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. We can get there. Is this the last round?
This is the last round of inclement weather.
All right, so we still have a plus 1 to our rolls here. Ouch.
You want to make explore?
I got a 1 on navigate.
Ah, oh, good. You save us.
I made my survival even though I didn't need to roll it.
All right, so we're on boss one.
We are on boss one. Boss one
on a boat.
Is the Bandit Prince. Do you want to show
everybody
the...
look at me.
The Bandit Prince.
A broat.
Yeah, broat.
Okay.
The Bandit Prince may have been born a nobleman's son, but all sense of honor has long since been stripped from the man. Even trusted friends and advisors have suffered his dishonesty.
Wait, is this card about the Bandit Prince or me?
Yes. He and his raiders have laid ruin to merchants and their caravans passing along the West Road for many years. Some whisper, however, that he is slipping into madness. His attacks have become more frequent and brutal. Best to bring him to justice, if you can.
Okay.
Maybe.
So,
So what difficulty are we on right now?
Let's pump up the GM.
You gotta stop that.
Where are we pumping it to?
So we could go to easy or moderate. If we go to moderate, he gets his passive ability.
Yeah, I see that.
Yes.
I think moderate will still be easy.
Let's do moderate.
So...
I mean, he is boss one,
yeah.
So...
Yeah. So, moderate, he's getting a plus 10 health and energy, and he's hitting us for how much more damage?
Plus 2 damage dealt.
Okay.
And boss's game passive. Plus 10 vitals per player, so he should be
right.
Plus 30.
He's getting 30 extra.
So
yep.
Instead of 25 health, he'll have 55 health.
55 health. And he has 46 energy. Okay, now he's humanoid. I'm good against humanoids. So first round, right out of the gate, I'm rolling 2 extra damage, which you can place in the non... refundable energy.
You must think you're pretty great.
Anything good over there for me to summon? What's better, direwolves or a living storm?
Hmm.
I see a 6 or an 8 here.
I'd probably say dire wolves.
Preferably something that won't siphon energy, since it's your job.
Entire group health, dual target health of 6, single target energy of 8. So you have 5 out of 6 chances at doing health damage with the wolves.
All right, give me the wolves. Summon some dire wolves.
Or replace it really.
Yep.
Raiders.
So this round, I am going to do Troll's Blood on you. That means that... can you grab the Black Market card that has Troll's Blood on it? Just on the back of that, I believe. So Troll's Blood. With the Apothecary, I can actually use Potion Smithing to create potions. So... actually, no. Troll's Blood is not what I need. I need Adrenaline Booster. I can't do it yet. Okay. Instead, I will just use Concentrated Formula, which increases one of the potions that I will use on one of you guys. So I'm going to be healing this round.
All right. Well, my Dire Wolves are going to do 4 attack damage. That seems pretty pathetic, Dire Wolves. Oh, they will make him bleed. Which will make him lose 3 energy.
Per round?
Yes.
Awesome. I also, at rank 7, I get to do 6 extra damage because I get to use Acidic Concoction as well. So he's taking 6 extra damage from me.
Okay. How much energy does he have?
He has 46. Oh, and because my summoning is rank 6, I get to add a d6 to my summoned action.
How much energy do you guys have?
We'll do an extra
you have 12?
Yeah.
Curtin, how much energy do you have?
11.
Could I siphon 5 from each of
you? Yep.
Oh my gosh.
Yep.
So I need to be buying energy.
No. If this works right, you should regain some of it. So I'm going to use Energetic Pattern. So the energy damage dealt to your target is equal to energetic pattern rank plus mental assault plus 4 energy siphoned. So my energetic pattern rank is 4, my mental assault is 6.
So that's 10.
So 10 plus 4 per energy siphon, so another 40 energy.
Yep.
So I do 50 energy damage total.
Beautiful. Awesome. So you lock him out of both of those 2 abilities round 1.
Beautiful.
And so at rank 7, oh, never mind. Disregard. I don't have
that yet. Okay. So does he do his passive first?
Here, yes.
During the declaration phase?
Yep.
During the declaration phase of each round, one hero must succeed on an explore check where the Bandit Prince's allies steal the least expensive item from their inventory.
Oh,
my explore is 5. Yours is a 6.
Well, we have to generate it.
Oh, we have to use it on the Bandit Prince.
Oh, okay.
All right, so time to explore. 3. Where did my dice go?
6. Sorry,
I made my explore.
Well, no. We're trying to determine a target.
Oh,
yes. One target.
Two of you.
So we have to both roll. So I'll re-roll a 6. I got a 1.
I got a 1.
We got to re-roll again. 8. Ah, all right. He's gonna take my least. My lowest one, which is a potion, unless I roll my explore. Now, are we still affected by the inclement weather?
Inclement weather.
I think this was the start of the next round.
Plus 1. Yes.
Okay, so I have to add a plus 1 to this. I miss it. So he takes the potion out of my inventory, which I was going to use on one of you guys, okay. And he uses it on himself.
So that gets him back 3 health and 3 energy.
Yep.
It just takes away the 3 that my direwolves did do.
Okay, and he is going to do 5. Greedy Hand.
Greedy Hand. The Bandit Prince steals 2 gold from each hero. The successful explore result reduces the amount by 1. If you don't have the gold to lose, you instead take 3 health damage.
How much gold?
3. Now, it increases because we're on moderate. So how much does that go to?
Plus 2 gold. Wait.
Plus 2 damage dealt?
Yeah, plus 2 damage.
So he's also doing health damage to us of 2.
So it's 3 gold and 2 health?
But we first have to roll our yellow to see if we have the number.
I made mine.
I missed mine.
All right, so if you miss it, he steals 2 gold from you. If you made it, he steals 1.
And how much health?
2 health.
2 health.
All right, so now that I don't have my potion in my pack, I'm going to use Mystic Tonic with my concentrated formula. That basically means that the item gains a boost to its numeric effects equal to half concentrated formula rank. So one of you is going to heal 9 energy. Who has the least?
I am only down 1.
Okay. You're going to gain
6 energy.
You're going to gain.
Did I get any energy back from your thing?
No, I.
Oh, if all goes according to plan, I lied about that. You had no intention.
If all went according to how I could read.
So you go up to full energy.
All right. So we only did 15 damage. We got to pick up the pace.
Yes.
Pace Picani sauce.
Okay. All right, I'm going to use invocation.
Full.
I can go up to full there.
Yeah. All right, so next round, I will just do concentrated formula again, doing 6 damage to him. I also do 5 points of non-negatable.
I'm going to use pattern surge, and I'll decide who it's going to be used on. But at rank 7, I can also use my mental assault this round, so I'm going to do 6 damage.
Okay, I am going to use Invocation, which will do 18 damage.
Nice.
And I also get to choose what the direwolves do. So they will do 6 health damage, and they get to roll a d6 for another 6.
Nice, and it explodes.
Another 6. So 15 for the...
Should have been rolling stats.
All right, that's a much better round as far as damage goes.
Okay, let's see what the Dead King... Nope, the Bandit Prince does 4. Garrote.
Well, he doesn't have any energy.
He doesn't have energy. So that defaults to block and stab.
Each incoming attack is reduced by 2 damage this round. Any target who damages the Bandit Prince takes 2 health damage, which cannot be defended against.
And it increases by 2 because it's now 4. So... We're all doing damage to him.
Yes.
So right. We all take 4 health damage.
So who is low? Anyone?
Not on health.
John, you're low on health and energy, but I'd have to pick. Do you have a preference?
I'm...
Energy, maybe?
Yeah, energy would be good.
On pattern surge? Okay.
Yeah, that would heal me of...
So you would get 8 energy healed.
Awesome. And that increases my total
right.
For this combat.
Right.
So I'm up to 14.
All right, and the Bandit Prince is dead.
Yes!
Woo! All right, so...
We did 61 damage that round.
Nice. All right, so that means we are getting 8 gold.
Do we get extra because of the difficulty increase?
Yes, you're right.
2 more.
So 10 gold, no, 6, so that's 12 gold total. We get 4 food.
I can't carry it. If you'd like, if somebody would like my 4 food.
I'll carry your 4 food.
We get to roll a d10 to see who gains the single award.
9.
9s.
6.
Roll off 9.
My direwolf's got a 0. I think they get the single award.
You get a +2 to your navigate.
Yeah.
And I get my darn potion back.
You loot it off his body?
Yeah, and then we get 4 power-up cards.
Wow.
Does he normally give you 2?
Yeah.
That's a change.
Yeah, we wanted bosses to feel more...
That definitely does.
Rewarding?
Rewarding. Rewarding. Okay, so we... Sorry, that was a weird noise, everyone.
French goblin.
Wee wee!
+1 survival, +1 first mastery, +1 defend, and then the epic, +2 attack and defend.
Wow, I got 3 out of my 4 cards are epics here.
I got I got +7 energy for Paul to siphon.
Yay, we're back. Okay. Sorry. It's a touch screen. I just want to make sure we didn't. Yep, we're good. We're recording, not recording.
In the year 2000.
Okay, so one last thing. After we've defeated the Bandit Prince, we get to see if the black market opens. And if we roll crappily, we can re-roll using our...
Or shrine ability.
Shrine ability, the blessing that we have.
Sweet.
So we need to roll a 1 on this die. You guys get to roll 2.
Oh.
Never mind.
Nope. What? How'd that happen? Okay.
You know, people are going to think, since we just started this video clip, that we rolled like 100 times.
Right.
Now.
I know. Like, we need to get the camera. Well, the camera's... That, we'll have to just shoot to that one.
Right. And just imagine that it's a one on that die.
Yeah. All right. So, Bezzelquark opens, gentlemen. So, that means, first of all...
Get your Bezzelquark.
Like, he opens, gentlemen? Like,
yeah.
With his knife.
Check it out. So, what do we
have? So, where does it open? Right where we are?
Right where we are, yeah. And we'll just use one. And the Dead King takes his first target. Boy, we really made him work for it.
Yes, we did.
So, I'm going to buy a Dryad's Amulet.
Nice. Those are really nice.
And a health stone.
I'm going to buy a couple of luck stones because I think we really need it. And I'm also going to buy the bone bowl. How much is the bone bowl?
Eight.
Is
eight
it
per hero?
Per hero, though? Yeah. Are you guys willing to go in with me on a bone bowl?
Which one does the bone bowl do?
So the bone bowl increases our favorite opponent die from a d6 to a d10, and it hexplodes on a roll of a 1 or a 10.
Yeah.
I mean, Bezzelquark's is pretty cool, too.
So it's 8
yeah.
per, right?
Yes.
So, yeah. That's fine.
I can give you 8 gold.
So with the health stone, John, automatically heals 3 damage when the hero reaches 1 or less remaining health.
Mm-hmm.
So does that mean if I was at negative 10, would I be at 3? Or would I be at negative 7?
So basically what would happen is you would drop to negative.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as you drop, then the health stone kicks in and you...
And I'm at 3.
And you're at 3.
Okay.
Right.
Now we heal our health and energy.
Yes.
At the black market.
Yeah, the black market is a city, so we get to buy stuff here as well. I am going to buy a couple of luck stones. I still have 15 gold. Do you guys want to... Do Bezzelquarks as well? We're getting double the gold.
I only have 2 gold left.
Okay.
I have 23.
Well, it's 10 per hero, so we need to come up with 30 gold.
Well, I have 23.
I have 15.
I'll give you 2.
Keep your 2, we'll take care of it.
All right, I'll put in 20, you put in 10?
Sure, or 15 and 15.
All right.
I'm okay with that.
Math works.
All right, so... So we have Bezzelquark and Bone Bowl now?
Yeah, can you pay 1 gold so that we heal completely?
I'll pay that 1 gold.
Thank you, sir.
Why do we need to pay gold for that?
We're in a city, and you have to pay one person pays a gold to heal full in a city.
Oh, that's new.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What if you're broke?
Then you don't heal.
Right, then you don't pay a gold to heal.
I'm going on strike, then.
then you camp
then
in the
you
wilderness.
Then you starve to death in the city like a beggar.
Yeah.
In the streets.
Okay, so what do we want to do?
So now you're talking about teleporting.
We were talking about teleporting there.
There.
Yeah. Yes. Why don't we do that?
Did someone buy a teleportation stone?
We did at that shrine. Somebody bought one.
Yeah, about that, guys. I think I forgot to buy one.
How much do they cost?
Well, you 6. Can't buy it at... The black market.
Or
though,
maybe
right?
I did and I didn't write it down.
I thought you did because I thought I gave you 3 gold for
check
it.
Check the tape.
Hold on. Cut.
Yeah. I paid for it, I'm pretty sure.
I'm pretty sure you took my money.
I'm pretty sure I paid for it and I just didn't write it down on my sheet. So I know. Because I was about to do it even, and that's probably why I didn't even write it down, because I thought we were gonna go right away. But then we did that guy. So
I really want to find a cave system now.
Yeah.
So we can get a ridiculous amount of money.
Can you grab another hex tile? We are unlocking another one here.
Living on the edge.
I feel like quoting Aerosmith now.
Put your hand down.
I'll take this one.
All right. Nice ruin nearby.
Ruin.
Okay, so we need to roll all 3 of our dice, unless we are living off the universe. I think we all
are.
We're
all
are
the universe.
I still managed to fail everything.
Oh, I made my navigate.
I made navigate as well.
Good.
And I get 4 gold. Ah!
You get 8 gold.
Bezzelquark's 8 gold.
Nice.
Okay, I feel like this is going to ramp up very quickly. Now, playing double up, generally speaking, is about an hour and a half game. Now, we're playing just for the fun of it here because, like, we are way than more than ready to face the Dead King whenever we want to, but I think we're just going to keep going.
Mm-hmm.
So, let's see.
I mean, things can go wrong very fast.
Right. Yes. Especially if we go up to Epic, which Epic. I think is something we should do.
Plus, you know. 300 vitals per player.
Yeah. Alright, 100 per player, and there's 3 players, so 300 total. Yeah. Okay, so now we're going to do a circumstance. Oh, sorry, no. We are on the second boss.
Oh, is he right under that quest?
He is right under this quest. Yeah.
The Gray Slime.
The Gray Slime.
Destroyer of Tasha Yar. Not much is known about this strange entity. It first emerged from the depths of the South Caves several years ago. Many have tried to fell the monster, but none have returned. Tales are told of mounds of bone near its lair. Able to alter its shape and color to mimic its environment, one can never be sure they're alone when near it. Be wary, traveler.
Nah.
Okay, so it's a magic nature? And it gets its passive.
Yep. Passive, it's growing on me. Anytime a hero is dealt damage by the Gray Slime, they suffer a cumulative -2 to their defense rank. This remains until the end of combat or until a hero defends.
Hmm.
Fun. Mm-hmm. Let's do this. I am going to open with... I'm going to make a adrenaline booster for... I'm going to make it for you, Paul. So you are going to gain, you get to roll a d6 and add it to whatever rank. Actually, can you grab that? It should say adrenaline booster on it. Thanks. So starting next round and lasting for 3 combat rounds, roll the 6-sided die each round and add the result to the rank of the action you make. So it's to the rank of your action.
Starting next round.
Next round.
Okay.
For the record, the Gray Slime has 66 health and 55 energy. I am going to summon those raiders.
Indiana Jones kind of raiders?
Humanoids, but I'm summoning them anyways. Raiders made out of earth and clay.
I'm going to use Pattern Surge, but I'm also going to then use my Mental Assault, so I'm going to do 8 damage. Or what type of creature is this?
Magical nature.
Oh, never mind.
Now, the other thing
so you're
is...
doing 8 damage?
8, yep.
Okay.
So, my potion smithing cost me 8 energy that round. The nice thing about the apothecary is I can also use my careful step, which is a defense action. And while you defend, you can also use an item. So, I'm going to use one of my mystic tonics on myself to also raise 7 energy. Or 6 energy, I think it is.
Is the Wilder stealing any of my energy?
I'm not yet.
Hmm. Confused. All right.
I will take all your energy next round.
My raiders are ganging up on the Gray Slime. So they will be doing 6 damage. Plus I rolled a d6, which exploded. So they'll be doing an additional 8 damage.
Nice.
Okay,
and the slime... it's doing 5. Slimy Osmosis.
Slimy Osmosis. The Gray Slime mimics an ability used this round.
Oh.
Roll the target dice. The slime mimics this target's ability.
Oh, crap.
I mean, I sure hope it uses Pattern Surge.
Yeah. On itself.
It might.
And, Raiders got a 10.
Okay, so whatever the Raiders did, it's going to mimic it.
So if the mimicked action is an attack, it does half damage. The mimicked action does not last beyond this round. So the raiders did a gang up, single target health of 6 damage.
So we have to determine who that's on?
Yep.
4.
4.
3.
And the raiders are a target?
No, the raiders are a target. Target of Al Davis.
3, so these two, we...
3.
6. I'm going to take 3.
You'll take 3 plus 2.
So five. Now, it's growing on me. Anytime a hero is dealt damage by the Gray Slime, they suffer a cumulative minus two to their defense. Now, I defended this round, but so I defend at rank eight. I don't take any damage, but I do take the passive. So I go down to six until the end of combat, or until I defend again.
So I still have to expend my pattern surge. Are either of you low on energy or health?
No.
Nope.
He took 22 health damage that time, so he's one third of the way down.
Okay. You're down one energy?
Yeah.
I will heal your one energy loss.
Awesome. That means I can do an adrenaline booster next round, if, or I can do something else too. Thank you. How much does it go up?
half pattern surge rank plus half absorb strength rank, so 3, 10. 10 energy.
Nice. So I am at 23 out of 12 energy currently.
But now I can't use this again on you while that's affecting you.
Right.
So I could use it again next round on Kurt or the Raiders.
Yep.
So my second round, I'm going to use Invocation, which will do 21 health damage. And the Raiders are going to gang up again, so they will do an additional 8.
I will use Concentrated Formulae, which it enhances an item, and I use it on myself or an ally. And I also do 10 damage to the Gray Slime.
That's going to put him very close to death.
How close? Well, I guess it depends on his ability, too, right? So
yeah.
He'll be within 10.
Can I soak 5 energy from both of you? Okay, good, thanks. I'm going to do that. So I'm going to use Energetic Pattern. And,
Take 5.
Yep.
Yes. You both lose 5 energy. So I'm going to do 50 plus 13. So 63 energy damage.
Excellent. That will take away his energy.
Okay, and the Gray Slime, 4.
He cannot do that. He has no energy.
Hey! Nice. He goes to shifting form.
The Gray Slime defends 6 damage from each attack. In addition, if your action is an attack against the Gray Slime, you suffer 2 energy loss.
Ouch.
Right, so that 8 is undefended.
It was if your attack is against the Gray Slime?
Yeah.
Do we suffer additional because of the difficulty?
Yeah, so it'd be 4. And each damaging attack is reduced by 6.
Does that include the energy damage I just did?
Yep.
Okay. Is it reduced by more than 6 because of the difficulty?
No.
Okay.
Just the damage.
How much total energy did he have?
He had 55.
He'd still be up.
Oh, okay. Yep.
Yeah.
All right, he has 17 health left after his offenses.
Well, I'm going to use Pattern Surge.
Well, one thing. We all got hit by the Gray Slime, so we all lose 2 to our defense again. Well, me again. You guys for the first time.
I get, what's the bonus that I get from your potion?
You get to roll a d6 and add it to your rank.
So I got a +2 last time and a +3 this time. So I'm going to take a +5. It'll be a +5 to my Pattern Surge.
Also, my concentrated formula that round was a mystic tonic on you, so you heal completely up to all of your energy.
All of it?
Yep. Because the mystic tonic is 6, and then my concentrated formula raises it by 5, so you'll be getting 11 energy back.
Okay, then I'm going to do another invocation. Raiders will do another gang up. Bonus damage.
Nice. Explodes.
Twice.
Twice again.
So 17 bonus damage down there.
I'm going to do 8 damage with Mental Assault, but I've also got Pattern Surge in case anyone gets hit here.
And I will just do Acidic Concoction for 10.
All right, there's no way this won't kill him.
All right, well, maybe.
No way.
2, he defends.
He defends again, all right.
So we're going to take 4 damage, energy damage. And he's likely very, very dead.
He's very dead.
Okay.
So, I'm down 11 energy. Kurt, what are you at?
I'm down 4.
I will use concentrated formula on you at the end of combat. This is actually a good thing to discuss. Any of our abilities, whether they are combat or otherwise, they can be used outside of combat. Now, most combat abilities obviously are not going to be able to be used outside of combat. But, for instance, my concentrated formula ability, I can use outside of combat. So I'm going to use that on you with a Mystic Tonic to heal you by 11 energy.
All right.
And there goes one of the Mystic Tonics you borrowed me.
Love you. So with Pattern Surge, which I still had cast, is it anything that's over the total?
Is lost.
Is lost, yeah. But everything else is okay, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm going to use Pattern Surge on you, John. Or how much energy are you down, Kurt?
4.
Okay, I'll use it on you, Kurt. So you heal all of it.
Nice. Okay, so the gray slime is dead. We each get 12 gold. Oh.
You mean 24 gold.
But before that, it goes up by 2, right? So yep. 8. So 8 plus 8 is 16, plus times 2, so 32 gold each.
Nice.
Double because of double up, and doubled again because we have Bezzelquark's Enhancifier. And now we are going to roll to see who gets the single target. Highest
10.
Two. You're getting the bonus plus 2 to survival. And then I'm getting another luck stone. Awesome. Do you want some of those luck stones to get rid of some of these cards? Would that help you?
Oh, we need there we go. Thank you.
Yep. Ooh, apparitions on.
Well, yeah, I mean we could use a luck stone to get rid of anything that's not an encounter. There's a lot of power-ups.
So, Paul, what are you thinking about the Wilder?
Pretty cool. I like that you can pretty much take a lot of abilities from the bosses, not to use, but you can eliminate, you know, most anything that requires energy, which is pretty cool. I got 3 epic cards.
That's what I got some epics last time too. Nice. Kurt, what do you think of the summer?
It's very versatile.
You're doing some loads of damage.
I like the kind of oscillation that it uses in going back and forth between these two abilities. And the system of managing your summoned creatures is interesting. I think it's good. Gives you some choice on every turn.
Yeah. Okay, awesome. Those are done for me. Okay, Dead King is going to select a new target. 5. He has to go. Where is City 5? He's on City 5. Right? Yeah.
5 again. He's lazy.
6, so he's coming back up here.
So stay out of his way.
All right, so we just completed a quest. So that means we're going to get the benefits of that bounty pretty soon here. All right, what do you guys want to do? There's a ruin over here. Should we try the ruin, or do we want to go fight the Megapede?
Yeah, what's the toughest boss around us right now?
Is this on that square?
Yeah.
4 and 5 are near us, right?
Actually, it's the square.
Oh, you're right, yep.
Alright, yeah, boss 5 would be
yeah.
A good one to take on.
I'd say let's do that.
If we do the ruin, we have a chance at fighting the next highest boss. So we have a chance of fighting the third boss, and we get double the reward if we do.
All right, let's go to the ruin.
We can also end up fighting a encounter as well.
Did you say we had some luck stones?
We do, yeah.
All right, let's use one to get rid of the sickened, the lucky rabbit's foot, and the strangle vines.
Okay. So we're using a luck stone right now, which is an item that you can purchase in the city, to...
and it's just the next 3, right?
Just the next 3, yep. To get rid of
Befuddled,
3 cards.
Will-O-Wisps and Thieves.
I could use... Why don't I use another one?
Yeah, get rid of Befuddled and Thieves.
We'll just do them one at a time. So Befuddled gets flipped over. Thieves get flipped over. Probably should have did this way the first time. And Grizzly. Friendly Merchant gets flipped over.
We don't need any Friendly Merchants.
Yeah, no. We're all about...
That one we can get dragons.
We're all about trying to... we transferred the Friendly Merchant and instead got injured. All right. Okay. So what do you think, guys?
Let's go to the ruin.
Yeah.
Okay. 1, 2. We're going to have to roll all 3 of our dice.
Well... Not survival.
Well, right. So not survival. I made navigate.
Somehow I failed them both.
I don't think I made it survival. Still don't need it.
Did you make your navigate?
I did not.
All right, we wander.
Do you want to try and reroll that die with our shrine?
What is it? How much energy?
It's 3 energy.
3?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Give it a try.
Nope.
I'll try. Nope.
No. Okay. So we wander. 6. We wander backwards. Okay, now we have one of these. We did not move cautiously, so we can't get rid of it. Will-o-wisps. We're fighting the will-o-wisps.
All right.
Now, I think we could probably just do this with, you know, their hands tied behind their back. Do we want to up the ante a little bit?
Yes.
Are we,
well, yeah. I mean, we're already on moderate, so... That is 44 health that they have.
Mm-hmm.
And 46 energy.
What's the next level up?
Difficult.
Yeah.
Goes to plus 25 per player.
Let's go to difficult.
Let's do it.
All right.
And we can go up but not down, right, John?
Yes, correct. So whenever you would like, you can increase the difficulty of Hexplorit. You can never go backwards, though. So we are making the calculated decision to fight Will-O-Wisps, not really considering that we will also have to fight the Dead King.
We're considering.
So
these Will-O-Wisps now have 89 health and 91 energy.
And they're doing 3 extra damage?
They're doing 3 extra damage.
Okay. Yes.
All right.
I guess I will summon... What does the apparition do? Does he do anything cool?
Single target energy, entire group health, and dual target health.
Nah.
Plus D10.
Give me the grizzly.
Alright.
Summon that grizzly.
Alright, I am...
Miss out on a giant eagle.
I am going to do adrenaline booster. And also careful step, which allows me to use a... Mystic Tonic on myself. So one of you will get a adrenaline booster.
All right. Grizzly.
I'm going to use Pattern Surge, and I'm going to do 12 damage with my Mental Assault.
I'm also using my Goblin ability to gain 2 gold worth of treasure, which is doubled because of Bezzelquarks. So,
my grizzly's bonus damage exploded once again.
Nice!
Alright, was anybody doing damage?
I am. 12 mental assault.
Okay.
And they do number 5.
Single target health. If the target suffers none, a second target suffers 8 damage.
So one of us is going to take 9 health damage this round. We have to do targets. 4, 7.
4, 8 for the grizzly.
Yeah, grizzly's taking the damage.
How much you take?
9.
9. That actually hurt the grizzly.
Now the okay, what else we got?
All right, that's the end of the first combat round.
I am going to use the adrenaline booster on you, Kurt. So you get to roll a d6 next round, for the next 3 rounds, and you get to add that to the rank of whatever you're doing.
Okay. John, I'm going to give you 19 energy.
Awesome.
With Pattern Surge.
So then this round, I will be doing potion smithing again to do another adrenaline booster, and it will be on you.
Okay. I'm going to use pattern surge again so that I can use it on Kurt, and I'll use I'll get 12 damage to mental assault.
Nice.
Okay, I'm going to need to do invocation for 23. My grizzly will do 6 again, plus bonus damage of 5.
Oh, what kind of creature is this?
Spirit.
Oh, look at that. So we get a d10.
Yes.
Right?
And it hex blows on a 1 or a 10.
So
a
9.
Plus 9.
And I forgot last time. Yep. I'm doing it anyway. 4.
All right.
So you can turn that 9 into a 13 at the bottom there?
I already added it.
Oh, okay.
Added it to his total.
Okay, so the spirit does 5 again. So one of us is taking 9 damage.
5.
9.
I got a 4 here and a 4 here.
So I
already used pattern surge on you, so I can't do it again.
Right, right. That's okay. Actually, I defended this round because I was using potion smithing, so I take none of that damage.
Nice.
My careful step is 10, so...
Kurt, you get 19 energy.
Thank you. And the Will-O-Wisps have 3 health remaining.
Nice. So you are now adrenaline boosted, and you are also adrenaline boosted. I'm just going to...
And what does that give us?
You get to roll a d6 and add it to your rank of your next action.
Oh,
I did not do that.
So then they're probably dead.
Well, invocation. Oh, yeah, add a d6. So add 4 to the rank. Yeah, that would do 4 extra damage.
Nice.
All right.
D-E-D.
Potion smithing for the win.
Yeah.
Potions killed him. 4 damage.
Okay, so we gain, what are we at, plus 3 to gold?
We are at plus 4 to gold.
Plus 4, so 11, so that's 22, 44 gold! It's becoming ridiculous.
We're probably going to spend some.
Yeah.
We haven't been in a city for a long time.
Yeah.
We have not.
Dead those King.
Pause circumstances.
Plus 3.
Well, my grizzlies as well.
We have harpies on the board.
Sweet.
Get your harpies.
All right. So the Dead King moved. We did not actually make our ruin. Do we want to try it one more time?
Yeah.
I lose that 17 energy that you fitted me with. So we're going to the ruin. This time we're moving cautiously, so we're just going to roll our yellow.
Found some gold.
Boy.
No gold.
You're getting 2, 4, 8 gold.
Yep.
No gold.
Okay, we don't have the circumstance. We do have the ruin event.
Ruins.
So you want to roll a d10?
3.
3.
Treasure chamber. You've found a treasure chamber. Each hero should be rolls. Explore with a -1 bonus to the roll. For each success, roll a 10-sided die and add it to 1 total. This die roll can explode. Each hero gains gold equal to the result rolled.
We're going to be richer than rich, folks. 2. I made it.
5. It's a explore roll?
Yeah.
I made it.
As did I.
All right, so we have 3 successes. So that means...
For each success, roll a 10-sided die and add it to 1 total.
9. 2.
6.
I'm going to use my... Shrine ability, the, what is it called there? So I think it's on the back side of that. Whatever shrine ability.
Oh,
we have.
The blessing?
Good fortune. I'm going to use good fortune to re-roll this die because I don't like it. 9.
Nice.
So, 24. 18, 24. So, how much gold do we get out of that? 24 gold?
Each hero gains gold equal to the result rolled.
24. So, playing double up. 48.
Bezzelquark. Mm-hmm.
Bezzelquark.
96.
96. Wow.
I have 187 gold.
I have 173.
You know, it actually costs about 300 gold to increase your character completely.
I think we should probably go to a city to upgrade and go fight the Dead King.
I think so too.
All right, well, I have 6 gold left.
My handy elixirs can now heal you guys for 10 health every round for three rounds.
What is food sold for? 3 food for 1 gold?
4.
4? Okay. Mm-hmm. I'm going to sell 2 gold worth of food. I'm just going to bump up my navigate.
Alright, I'm ready.
No, I'm out of money. Well, I feel like I spent my money well. Oh, and I... Okay. Got my scroll.
We should get ready with the... with the undead as well. His passive is gonna... get us here. We may have already fought. Can you look for the other undead that are in there, please?
Yes.
There should be a level 3.
Apparition? Oh, that's spirit. Yep. Plague beast?
Yep.
Vampire?
Yep. And then there should be the last one, should be Bone Legion. Oh, that one's right here. Okay. So, the Dead King's passive is each turn, the lowest level undead joins the battle with him. Can you put those in the discard pile? All right. So, that means we're fighting some pretty hard things here. But we have a little bit of time before he gains enough power. So, do we want to fight him where we're at on difficult, which is the fourth out of 6 difficult levels?
Yes.
I'll defer to you, Kurt.
let's keep going on difficult.
Okay.
Sounds good to me.
Okay.
I suspect it's going to be difficult enough.
Yeah, especially with the extras that he brings into the group.
Right.
Okay. Scourge of this valley, for hundreds of years, the Dead King has mostly kept out of mortal affairs until now. Though some have tried defeating him, none have succeeded. All who go up against him eventually fall to his power and join his ranks as one of the undead. I fear the population is close to deserting this valley, for the Dead King now moves, seeking to destroy life wherever he can find it. All right, what does he got? He has 140 health.
Plus... Well, the multiplier is going to make it 215 health.
All right.
195 energy.
Okay. So, hit Legion of Darkness. Every turn, the Dead King calls the lowest level undead encounter from the circumstance deck or discard pile to fight for him. Roll the encounter dice at the same time as the Dead King. So, round one, he'll get the skeletons.
Is that cumulative?
Then round two is the zombies, yeah.
So round two will be skeletons and zombies?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep. All right. So the opening round, I'm going to use concentrated formula to use a handy elixir that is going to heal one of you for 10 health for the next 3 rounds. So that's going to be what I'm doing. I'm also using acidic concoction to do 18 damage to the Dead King.
All right. I'm going to summon that giant eagle.
Yeah, you are.
And the giant eagle is going to do 8 damage, or 8 health damage, plus a bonus of 4 damage.
Wherever that went. Oh, I see it. There. I get towards you, maybe.
It's gone forever. This is it.
Here.
All right. Bonus damage of 1.
Worth it?
Nope. Yeah, I don't see it.
All right.
I'm going to use Pattern Surge, and I'm going to do 17 damage with my Mental Assault.
Okay, and I'm doing 2 bonus damage because... oh, wait, no. That's a D10, not a D6 now. I'm doing an extra 4 damage.
4 extra.
All right, that is my movements.
And what are you doing?
I'm doing Pattern Surge, so once someone takes damage, I'll
Okay.
On the side.
Dead King does Power Incarnate. The Dead King acts twice this round. Roll the boss die twice more. If you roll another 3, the Dead King defends 30 damage this round. If you roll another 3, all heroes lose all energy. I'm going to not roll that.
All right. There's a 4.
Okay. Essence of Death. Group energy. The Dead King siphons your life essence. Each hero loses 12 energy plus
3.
3, so 15 energy. I can't read upside down. Can you read the rest of that?
And one target begins to wither, losing half the remaining health at the start of each round. This ability cannot kill a target, nor can it be reflected.
Okay, so we need to generate a target to take the wither.
2.
10, 3.
So you're going to be losing half your health each round.
Okay.
I'm using my handy elixir on you, so you are actually going up 10 health every round for the next 3 rounds.
Okay.
So I can lose half your health and then gain 10.
That'd be interesting. All right. Everybody loses 15 energy.
Everybody loses 15 energy. I'm down to 0. Which means I can't use Handy Elixir next round.
I can when I use Pattern Surge on you, potentially.
Okay.
But let's see what his second.
So the second ability is 5, Entropic Wave, Group Health. The Dead King unleashes powerful waves of magic, which warps life. Each hero suffers 8 health damage, so 11 health damage, and one hero rolls Explore. If you fail your next round, you fight for the Dead King against your allies.
So you're 9, right?
Yeah.
Or do we have to determine who?
We have to determine, yeah, so...
8.
3. So we each take 11.
Okay. So we take 11 damage.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm the target of that, right?
Yep.
So I need to make my explore roll.
Yep.
Can I decide if I want to use my racial ability after I roll?
Yeah.
I make it.
Yeah. Okay, now the skeletons go. So the skeletons roll a 1, single target health, and the target does 4 less damage this round. So one of us is going to take 6 damage.
10.
Wow.
8.
1.
10.
Ouch. So you're going to take 6 damage, and you do 4 less health damage to the Dead King.
Is it more than that because of the difficulty?
No.
Oh, okay.
Well, I didn't do any damage.
Then
my
it doesn't.
Giant Eagle did damage.
Then it doesn't. Yep, you don't have anything. Okay, good.
All right, so I'm using Pattern Surge on you. You're going to get 22 energy.
That is actually very helpful. Thank you.
It's right. Better than 0.
Yes.
I'm going to, for the first time this game, use my Dark Dwarf racial ability. Dark Dwarves are narrow-minded and focused. Once per game turn for 2 energy, they may shrug off any ongoing negative effects which trouble them.
Nice.
So that will end
Sweet.
The essence of death on me.
Nice.
That's
nice.
What I have my Dryad's Amulet for, something quite similar.
Okay.
All right, so we did 28 damage to him that round.
I am going to have to use my Pattern Surge on myself to regain energy next round, I believe.
Okay.
But we'll see.
Actually, sorry. I use a Handy Elixir, so that means it's both energy and health that you're getting back. 10 each round.
Perfect.
So why don't I do the same thing on you this round? So you'll heal 10, allowing you to do another Pattern Surge.
Or I can still do a Pattern Surge.
Okay. Okay, so that's what I'll do. I'm going to use Concentrated Formula again to use one of my handy elixirs on you. Paul, you're going to gain 10 health and energy for the next 3 rounds.
Okay.
All right, so my...
How are you guys on energy right now?
I'm okay at the moment.
I'm good.
What is it considered okay?
21.
Can I...
Yes.
Can I have... 15.
Why not?
Sure. Yeah. Go ahead.
I hope you do something cool with it.
So I'm going to use Energetic Pattern, and since I'm high enough, I can also use Pattern Surge. So I am out of energy, but I'm going to do... Let me do some slow math here. So I took 15 from each of you. Yep. So that's going to be 120 energy damage plus 32. So 152 energy damage.
That's most of his. I still have...
But then I also get to use Pattern Surge, so I'm going to do that plus 17 regular damage for Mental Assault.
Okay.
Nice.
My Giant Eagle is going to rend for 9 damage, and I am going to do Invocation for 38 plus 5 bonus damage against the undead.
When do I get the 10?
Right
now. Is it right away?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, and then he goes... this round, the Bone Legion, group survival. If you succeed, you deal half damage to the Dead King. If you fail, the Bone Legion absorbs the damage. If more than half the heroes fail, the Bone Legion absorbs all damage dealt this round, and Murder of Crows also takes effect. So we need to roll survival.
Survival round.
3.
I made it with a 9.
I made it with a 9 as well. All right, so we get half the damage through?
Yep.
All right, so...
Ouch.
4, that's 19. That's 8.
Suddenly all that energy loss hurts.
And now, do you still have Pattern Surge on you?
No, because I
you've used it?
Yeah, it's dropped underneath.
Okay.
All right, so I regain 10 energy.
Now the skeletons go for entire group health of 5 damage. This damage may only be reduced to a minimum of 1. So we each take 5 health damage. And zombies join him. Dual target health, and each target is infected, doing 6 less damage each round.
Ugh.
Ouch. All right, so we need 2 targets.
10.
3-3.
All right, so it's me and you.
I'm going to use my Dryad Amulet to negate it. So I can't do that again for another 3 rounds.
Okay, and that means I'm doing 6 less damage each round. All right, this turn...
All right, so after 2 rounds...
Is it the end of the turn?
Yeah.
So I'm still going to do Pattern Surge. How are you, Kurt?
The Dead King is at about 70% of his original health.
Looks like you're okay on energy.
Okay, as long as you're not stealing 15 energy.
I mean, I could. John, you're going to get 22 energy again.
Awesome.
Now, with that potion, do we heal at the beginning of the turn?
Yeah, it's right.
Or is it at, when everything resolves?
It's whenever.
Okay.
It's at the beginning, yeah.
Okay.
All right, so Giant Eagle is doing 10 damage. I'm doing Invocation for 38 and 9 bonus damage.
Okay, I am going to do... I'm going to do a Adrenaline Booster and defend this round.
I'm going to take... 5 energy from each of you, if that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so I'm going to do 72 energy damage and 17 regular attack damage.
When he did Power Incarnate, he spent 5. So that should be, he should be out.
No, not even close.
Oh, okay.
Because he only took half of...
He took half.
Oh,
right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
All right. So Dead King.
So yeah, I'm still doing Pattern Surge this round.
2 again. Ouch. I think we're going to lose this battle because the vampires are
Quiet.
Coming on now. Okay. Go ahead. So.
All right, so group survival again.
Group survival.
Let's see if we can both make it with a 9 again.
8. I made it.
I made it. Oh, I rolled the wrong die.
Sorry.
I made it. Still made it.
Nice. Okay.
All right, so half of that.
At least he didn't act three times. So, skeletons, single target health, and the target does 4 less damage this round. So, one of us, we have to generate a target. 10. Okay, and now we have the zombies, dual target health, and each target is infected. So another 2 targets.
6 and 3.
I'll roll for you, Paul. 5 and 6. You guys.
Six, okay.
So did I get affected by the first attack?
No.
Oh, okay.
Just the second.
All right, so what are the zombies doing to us?
They're doing 7 damage. And you do 6 less damage next round. And finally, the vampires. Dual target energy. If one of you run out, both suffer 1 health, and the vampire defends at rank 4. Okay, so dual target energy. This is an energy attack. 2 targets.
8.
There's a 6 and a 6.
Alright, so you guys have to reroll.
5.
So, okay, you're gonna take 7 energy damage.
Okay. I can take that. I don't wanna blow my racial yet.
D6 is still missing.
Oh, we'll find it. Yeah.
All right, so what happens to the giant eagle?
Giant eagle just takes 7 energy, so that's probably okay.
He doesn't even use energy.
Yeah.
All right, so the dead king is just over half health.
Okay, and next turn the plague beast comes on the board. All right, so I used a adrenaline booster. Who would it be best used on?
This is my last round, I think, for the other potion.
Okay.
How long did that potion last that you're using?
3 rounds.
3 rounds. Okay, so I just used it for the third and final round. But I'm at full health, and I've got 19 energy. I'm in decent shape.
I'll use it on you, so next round, for the next 3 rounds, you're getting to roll a d6 and add it to... well, actually, potion smithing is increasing it as well by 3. So you roll this, you add 3.
So I didn't...
your rank.
I didn't resolve my... pattern surge from last round.
Okay.
You're at 4 health.
Yep.
So you're going to get 22 health.
Nice. Thank you. I'm up to beyond 4.
All right. So start of round 4.
Okay.
All right. So Giant Eagle is going to do 8 again. Plus 4.
I'm going to do a concentrated handy elixir 1 more time. To increase one of us by 10 health and energy.
Alright, so you said I roll this,
yep.
Add 3 to the rank of what I'm doing?
Yep.
Alright, so 6 to my invocation.
How is he on energy right now?
107 out of 195.
You can take all 10 of mine.
Alright, I'm doing 44 on my invocation. Oh, I didn't roll my bonus undead damage last round.
But you're going to need energy to do one of your abilities, right?
Leave 2. You could take 8.
Okay. Kurt, I'm going to take 8 energy from you, then 2.
Okay.
This is a tough battle.
Well, he keeps defending so much.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm going to do... 116 energy damage and 17 regular damage.
Nice.
And please don't defend on that, Dead King.
I won't roll it. It's over there.
There it is.
Oh, two again.
Third straight.
Hang on. Hang on. So you used 8 of my energy, right?
Yep.
Oh, I don't have 3 left. You use 3 energy to re-roll that die.
From the
blessing. Yeah.
Yes. We're doing that. 6.
Murder of crows. The Dead King unleashes a swarm of crows. Each hero loses 2 health at the beginning of each round until the end of combat.
It's +3, so 5.
Okay. Each time this is rolled... Well, we haven't rolled it more than once. Okay.
At when? The beginning of combat?
Beginning of each round, we'll lose 5
health, right? Okay.
Yep. So first, now the skeletons go. 2 single target health, so we need to generate a target. 1.
8.
2.
8. You're the target. You're going to take 6 damage. Health damage. Zombies. 5 single target health, and the target may not use energy next round. 1 of us. Okay.
1.
1. All right, so the giant eagle can't use energy. That was a good round for that.
Did he take health damage?
Single target health of 8.
Okay, he has 1 health left.
3.
Eagle.
Vampire, dual target energy. If one of you run out, both suffer 1 health, and the vampire defends. Okay, so we need 2 targets. 8.
5.
7.
So we're both the targets. We're both taking 7 damage.
Okay.
Health damage. Alright, Plague Beast is on the board. 4, they do entire group health and roll survival. Any hero who fails also loses all energy. Entire group health, roll survival.
Alright, Giant Eagle's dead.
6.
Oh, I made it.
Survival? Yeah.
Made it.
Okay. So that just means we take dual target health and energy of 9. We take 9 health and energy. Ooh.
9 health and energy?
Yeah. Holy cow.
I have 1 energy left.
I'm going to have to heal myself.
So I haven't used my Andy Elixir concentrated yet.
Hold up. I can use my Dryad's Amulet now this round. So I'm going to get rid of that -5
that
would be suffering, although I'm at 3 health. So I still have to resolve my pattern surge.
Resolve it on you if you can, and I can use Handy Elixir on me, or vice versa. I can use it on you, and then you can raise.
But neither of you have any health or any energy.
Right.
Are you going to be able to do anything next round without any energy?
Dead King has 19 health left.
19? Oh 19. My god, okay.
And I lost my giant eagle.
All right.
I'm healing myself for 22.
I'll use the handy elixir on myself, which raises me by 10 each. The round rolls over, and we each lose 5 health from crows.
Except, not me, I used the Ride's Amulet. Yep.
15. Okay, guys. Last round of the game.
Okay, well... What's left that I can summon?
Brigands, harpies, a cyclops, or a living storm. Cyclops sounds awesome.
I see a 7 over there.
Yeah. 8 energy. The 7 is health.
Yeah, give me that cyclops. This is my last energy.
Okay. Alright, so now we've got... let's see. I'm going to do... Holy crap, this is going to be hard.
All right, the Cyclops is going to do 6 health. And he gets a bonus of 4.
I'm going to use Potion Smithing this round and heal one of us with a potion.
And I get undead bonus damage of 8.
Can I siphon 1 energy from each of you?
I have no energy left, so no.
Yes, you can from me. You can siphon more from me if you want.
Well, it says from each of her allies, so does that mean...
He doesn't have any left, so you can siphon 2, and it takes 2 from me.
So I'll siphon 2 from you then, John.
Okay.
So I'm going to do 36 energy damage and 17 regular damage.
You know he has no energy already.
Oh, he is at nothing?
Yeah, he's out.
Oh, do I get it back then? Okay.
No take backs. All
right, so 36 energy and how much health?
17 health.
Okay.
And then I'm also using Pattern Surge this round.
Okay, Dead King. Two!
He defends
again. He's Jeez. Just defended this entire... He's just letting his lackeys take us out. All right, so everybody roll survival.
4.
Made it.
With a 7. All right. Skeletons.
It's a war of attrition, though.
Yeah, entire group health. This damage may only be reduced to a minimum of 1. So we're each taking 5 points of damage, of health damage. I'm only taking 1 because I defended. Zombies. Entire group health and any target who suffers damage may not use energy next round. Now, I defended, so I can use energy next round. You guys are taking 6.
6 health?
Yep.
And we can't use energy?
And, yeah, next round you can't use energy. Mm-hmm. Vampire, 2. Dual target energy. If one of you run out, both suffer 1 health, and the vampire defends at rank 4. So 2 targets. 1.
10.
9, 8.
So
the 9 and the 10.
Yep, so you each take 7 energy damage.
And if we run out, what?
If you run out, the vampire defends.
Okay, well, I ran out.
Yeah, Plague Beast, entire group energy, and roll survival each round. Healing effects fail until you succeed. Okay, so
my potion is going to 7
energy damage.
I'm
defending.
I'm out of energy. I was down 2, 1 health and 0.
You have to roll survival.
Well, the Dead King has
if
negative
you fail, and the Bone Legion is on the board.
Nice.
Wow.
2. Entire group health, this damage may only be
nice.
Reduced to a minimum of 1. So entire group health is just
bombarded.
We're each taking 6 health damage.
Wow.
Well done. Okay.
Well, that couldn't have been much closer.
So we were fighting them.
Oh, right. We do saw that. I have 1 health and 0 energy.
Okay. So my...
I'm going to use Pattern Surge on myself to heal myself for 23 health.
Awesome. Here.
For sure.
I can't use energy next round anyway, so it doesn't really matter.
Having healed, I can't use energy, nor do I have any.
We never okay, and I have not used the enhanced potion yet, so who needs the potion?
To appear. So
we also lucked out quite a bit in that he had a long way to go.
There
I mean,
we go.
Yeah, we got to play for a long time without losing too many cities.
So here's the Apothecary. As you can see, we got him pretty high with several things there. My highest was my health at 25.
Here's the Wilder. You can see I was able to spend quite a bit and get a lot of stuff upgraded, plus all the other awesome stuff that we had.
And Chair the Summoner.
Chair the Summoner.
Wouldn't we all like to summon a chair?
To sit in, now that his work is over.
Yeah. So, thanks again for watching, everybody. We hope you learned quite a bit about the game or how it's played. If you have any questions, feel free to let us know, and I'll try to answer them as best I can. Thanks again for watching.